We've got a black Golf R today, which is nice. And that's pretty loud. Man, this is freaking slow. That was weird. Okay, here we go. What's up, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to this POV review by Autotop.nl. My name is Max, and today we've got another Mannhardt car, and it is a Volkswagen Golf R. It is, well, one of the most loved hot hatches ever made, and we always see that because a lot of you guys watch the videos with Golf R's and you comment a lot and you like it a lot. So yeah, we thought let's do a tuned one again, and this is a 450 horsepower Mannhardt Golf R with, of course, some minor changes, but this is a very safe tune, and that emphasizes the character of the Golf R. It should be drivable every day, no hassle, no problems, just a fast, everyday, practical hatchback. So today I'm going to show you around it, show you all the changes, show you all the Mannhardt parts, then we'll take it for a drive towards the Autobahn for an Autobahn blast. But before we begin, don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell if you want to receive updates when we upload a new video, and check us out on Instagram if you like, at Autotop.nl. So we've got a black Golf R today with, of course, the Mannhardt striping, Mannhardt sticker on the window. We've got a Rieger front splitter, which gives it a little bit more of an aggressive look, with a little gray pinstripe as well on there. But it does look very mean, this car. Yeah, I think it looks good. We've got some Mannhardt wheels, which fit beautifully on this car. Actually really like it, 19 inch. Beautiful. These Mannhardt concave wheels, we have them on a lot of different cars, but they seem to fit on all cars really well. So that's a good job by Mannhardt. RS 450 badge on the side, Mannhardt logo, Golf R logo, silver mirrors, limited, number 1 of 10, this car. And at the rear, we've got, of course, the quad exhaust. And this car also has a resonator delete and it's a different downpipe. So it does sound a little bit better than stock. Let me know what you guys think of this car, the way it looks, the way Mannhardt has changed it. You can elaborate in the comments and let me know what you think. So let's take a look at the engine. So we've got the 2-liter TSI with stock 300 horsepower, now around 450, 500 newton meters of torque, and we've got a carbon fiber air intake by Mannhardt as well. And as I said, a different downpipe, and that resonated delete, which makes it a little bit louder. It has, of course, some exhaust valves, so if you go to race mode, the valves open. So yeah, it's actually quite nice, this carbon air intake. Looks cool. Not that much to see there. So on the inside there are not that many changes, apart from the fact that we've got some different pedal shifters, which are not glued onto the stock ones, but they are just new ones, which I always prefer, with a little bit of a weird shape, but they're nice. Golf R steering wheel, of course, we've got these Golf R seats. They are nice and snug. And DSG gearbox. What else? So the interior is not really the important part of this car, of course. So let's take it for a drive and see what it's like. We'll just go to race mode. Oh, we are already in race mode. Sport for the gearbox. And we're off. So you immediately feel that, oh, I forgot a very important part about the tuning. It has a bigger turbo. So you immediately feel that it takes a little while to spool up, a little bit longer than usual in a Golf R. But once it does, you do get a nice shove. It is nice and powerful, this car, and combined with that sound, it actually makes for a lot more interesting driving experience than stock, because a stock Golf R, although it is super great to have every day and it is a nice fast car, it is a little bit boring. I mean, I think we can agree on that, right? Compared to like a BMW M140i with a six cylinder, this is a little bit boring. That exhaust combined with that bigger turbo means that the driving experience is a lot nicer in this Mannhardt version. And, well, of course it's faster as well. So a stock Golf R does 4.6 seconds from 0 to 100 kilometers an hour. This Mannhardt version with 450 horsepower. Well, let's see. Traction control off. Gearbox in sport. Full throttle. And there we go. And that is, well, I don't know if that was, but we have measured it at 3.8 seconds from 0 to 100, which is really quick. That's seriously impressive. And you can also, you can hear that new intake. When you let off the throttle, you can hear it blowing off the excess air. Okay, so windows down a little bit for the tunnel. You get some nice loud bangs as well on the upshift, and I haven't heard them yet, but sometimes you also get these burbles. See, that's good, it's not all the time, so you don't really get tired of them. There they are. That's pretty loud. So of course the DSG gearbox, the all-wheel drive, it means that this car is super easy to drive, and well, it feels like it's really hard to upset this car, which it always is. But this car also has H&R springs, which means that it sits a little bit lower and it's a little bit firmer, and it means that where the regular Golf R always feels very, very, you know, safe and very understeered, this feels a lot more neutral because it is stiffer and harder. It feels a little bit more agile and a little bit more like you can throw it into a corner without it, you know, screaming in agony, which is nice. So all these changes, they're not massive changes, they're not changing the character of the car too much, but what Mannhardt have done with this car is make it just a little bit more aggressive in every way. So the power is more aggressive, the power delivery is more aggressive, the suspension is more aggressive, the sound is more aggressive, and those are all things a stock Golf R can really use, because it means that it's so much more exciting. So it's a great package by Mannhardt. Now, of course, we're going to test it on the Autobahn as well, so I'm going to get my digital speedo right there for you guys, and we'll see what it's like on the Autobahn. Okay, here we go. On the Autobahn, so let's check out those H&R springs, because sometimes when you lower and stiffen the car, it becomes unsettled on the Autobahn. But I can already tell that this is absolutely fine. Little bumps, no problem. Already doing 260, that's not bad. 270. it's seriously quick. Is that a limiter to 83? I think so. That's a weird number for a limiter. That was weird. It is seriously fast. Wow, that's actually impressive. So it does 9.94 seconds from 100 to 200. And that is half a second quicker than a BMW M2 competition, which is impressive, I would say. If you want to check out the acceleration runs and stuff on the Autobahn, you can check it out in the top right corner. Oh, this feels so like standing still after you do 280 and then go back to 90. Hate it. I would say the bigger turbo also on the Autobahn really makes you feel like, you know, it's got some proper power. If you drive a stock Golf R at like top speed or around the top speed, you feel like it's really, it has to push. It has to extract every last bit of power from that engine to make you go that fast. With this one, it feels much more easy and like it doesn't really have to try that hard, which is nice. It's a good feeling because it feels like it has a little bit more of a reserve. Man, this is freaking slow. Overtaking with 88 kilometers an hour. Okay, last full throttle. To the exit, because we're going to turn around here. That is fast. Little bumps, soaked them up nicely. Yeah, this is definitely a nice package for any Golf R owner. I would definitely recommend anyone who has a Golf R and wants to do some cool stuff to it to go to Monhardt. It might not be the first one you would think of if you would want to tune your Golf R, but it's a nice package. They're still developing it, so I think they will get even more power out of it. But this is already really nice. This is also quite impressive. So we are back at the gas station, and that means that I'm going to end this review. You can subscribe by clicking the big button right here. You can also check out this video or go check out this playlist if you want to see more. Thanks so much for watching, and I hope to see you at the next one. Bye guys.